Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 11.5. At number one, we're asked to graph the following equations. And the final answer here, we want to graph these equations in the xy plane. So the first thing I always do is I graph them in the r theta plane. And I usually graph one period of it, one cycle. So if I want to graph 4 sine theta on the r theta axis, I go in, put in my quarter marks, and since I haven't adjusted the theta at all, it's the same 4 quarter marks I had before, and then I go in, plug in the values, I've got an amplitude of 4. That. Okay, so now I go over to the xy plane and what I want to do is use this information to graph the equation over here. So let's look and see what happens as I go through this. As theta goes from 0 to pi over 2, the r goes from 0 to 4. So remember, r is telling you how far away from the pole you are. So over here, I start off, theta equals 0. And then this is theta equals pi over 2. And so I'm rotating here. All right, so I'm rotating this way. I start off at r equals 0. And by the time I get to pi over 2, I've gradually increased out to 4. That. Okay? So you can think of these r values here as sweeping out from the pole, from the origin, that way. Then from pi over 2 to pi, what's going on with these r values? They're tucking themselves back in. So theta equals pi is over here. So we're coming in this way. So from being 4 units away from the pole, they're coming in and tucking themselves back in there. And so they're gradually decreasing. And so we get that. Now this is the tricky bit. At pi, we're going to pass through the pole because we've got a 0 there. And now the r values become negative. So they go from 0 to negative 4. Now what's that negative do? You can still think of this as going from the pole to 4 units away from the pole. But since they're negative r values, we're starting the rotation from the negative x-axis. So if I start from the negative x-axis and rotate pi, so if I start here and rotate pi, I'm actually going to be plotting up in here. So pi to 3 pi over 2 rotation from the negative x-axis is actually going to have me back in quadrant 1. And because of the symmetry of the sine function, the r values I'm getting out here correspond to the same r values I had up here, which means I'm going to start retracing this curve. And from 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi, once again, all the r values are negative. If I start here and rotate 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi, from the negative x-axis, I'm going to be plotting back in quadrant 2 again. So that's the thing you got to remember. When you cross through the theta axis on this graph, you cross through the pole over here. And so you plot in the reflected or the opposite quadrant you would expect to be plotting in. Okay, you reflect through the pole, reflect through the origin. So the final graph of this thing, we want to sharpen it up a little bit. Looks to be like this. And in fact, this one you can convert back to rectangular coordinates and see that you get an honest-to-goodness circle. All right, so that'll do it for part A. Okay, in part B, we're asked to graph r equals 4 sine 3 theta. And so we'll see how that 3 is going to change things from what we had before. So thinking back to 10.5, what do we know what that 3 does? That 3 is the angular frequency, which means that this sine curve is going to go 3 times as fast as this one. So instead of going from 0 to 2 pi, it's going to go from 1 cycle will go from 0 to 2 pi over 3. So the quarter marks then are going to be at pi over 3, pi over 6, and then pi over 2. The amplitude is still 4. And so when I plug in these values, and connect them up there in the usual sine fashion, oops, I get the typical sine curve. So I want to see what that's going to look like then over here. So as we talked about in class, the zeros of this function, the places where this curve crosses through the theta axis, are going to correspond to the places where the curve passes through the pole. And these angles then correspond to the tangents at the pole. So what I'm going to do is dot in theta equals pi over 3, which is a line through the pole that makes an angle pi over 3. And then theta equals 2 pi over 3. And now I'm going to see how this goes. Okay, so between theta is 0 and theta is pi over 3, the r starts at 0, increases to 4, and decreases back to 0. That means that we're going to move out from the pole 4 units and come back in. And we're going to max out at pi over 6, which is halfway through the rotation. So about halfway through this rotation, I'm going to start here. About halfway through, I'll be 4 units out, and then I'll come back in. So we're going to have this nice symmetric curve like that, okay? From pi over 3 to 2 pi over 3, the r value is negative. So instead of graphing here, which is where we would graph if we had a positive r value between theta equals 2 pi over 3 and theta equals pi over 3, I'm going to be graphing down here. So I cross through the pole, go out 4 units, and then tuck back in. And this should, all these things should be symmetric. I'll do the best I can, but they're all supposed to be symmetric. Like so. And so that's what you would get if you just plotted the first cycle of this function. But we know that this is just one cycle, and so it actually continues onwards. So where would this end up? Well, let's see. A second cycle would go from 2 pi over 3 to 4 pi over 3. And so we would have another 0 here at pi. So we have pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, and then 3 pi over 3, or pi. And so what's going on between 2 pi over 3 and pi? The r value starts at 0, so we're back at the pole, increases to positive 4, then decreases back to 0. So between theta equals 2 pi over 3 and theta equals pi, the r is positive, so we're going to be graphing in here, and we're going to have another one of these loops. Once again, it should be a symmetric loop. Oh, it's not working for me today. Now between pi and 4 pi over 3, which would be what's going on down here, in this region, R is negative, which means I'd actually be graphing up in this region again. And because all these values are symmetric, I would just be retracing what I already did. So this tells us that we have a three-leaf rose. And I could try to draw it again to make it more symmetric. I don't think I'm going to be successful because it's just going to be one of those days today. But all these leaves should be symmetric. They all should come into the pole hugging those tangent lines. I'll do one last try here, and then we'll just have to call it a day. Okay, so all these should be symmetric. They should all look the same. I'm just not going to be able to get it to look like that. Anyway, that's the procedure. That's what you do, and that'll do it for part B.